Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Can you still hear him?
Nope, just you!
Good! Now hang on! Andiamo!
All right, let's get this going. Hope everybody is doing well tonight. We have some big marbling to do today, so that's going to be super exciting. Okay. My wife is going to return momentarily. We got to have like this whole space cleared out so we get plenty of room. For our marbling tray. So, we got a paper sitting over here on the back bench. So these have all been previously alumed. Throw that down there. So that's why they're curling up a little bit. So the alum, if you're unfamiliar with the marbling process, alum is like a mineral that comes out of the ground, and it's used primarily in dyeing things. So like if you wanted to like dye threads or strings and things, you would use alum to help that silk, or especially something like cotton or linen, that alum helps it to absorb into the fibers a lot better. It's something that Florence, Italy was actually famous for during the Renaissance period. Partly what got Renaissance caught up in so many wars, actually, in the first place, was fighting over that alum. But anyway, so you take that alum, you can dissolve it in water, and we're putting it on these pages because we need these pages to absorb a lot of color when we marble it. So those that alum's been previously applied. Like I said, that's kind of why the paper's curling. So those have all been prepped off camera. Starting soon. This is rubbish. Yeah, well, blame Loretta. Right, yeah. You like the starting soon pages.
Because we are literally not ready to stream. But thank you all for being here. Get to be part of our chaos.
I don't know, I think we should just get started whenever.
I like to try and be kind of professional.
Okay, so here we go.
Because you're putting all this over here and I need to lay the drop cloth down.
Are you going to put it on top of the... Are you going to have it, like, water falling off the table?
Yes. Yes. Oh, sorry, I just had to move the mic for a minute.
Go here, put it on top so we get some weight.
I was trying to move it.
Hopefully we don't accidentally pull the cloth and pull everything off with it.
That would not be good.
It'd just be another day.
Another day.
So excited. We have a couple different projects that we need to get some end pages prepared for. So the first one primarily is going to be Pride and Prejudice. So I'm really excited at least to do that book. So that one, or actually, were you doing the end pages for that one? Not today?
No, we're just doing the Christmas ornament today.
Just the Christmas ornaments today? So do you need this?
No, I just need to put it away.
Okay, I'll just put it over.
Here's our little tray. Let's see if I can keep that in camera. So that's good there.
If you want it further in, we can just tilt that down.
I mean, it's fine because we got to pull it off the table anyways. I'll put my paints up here.
Okay. Just wherever is comfortable, I guess. Now I'll move this one in. side view of that. One angle. And a side view from the other angle.
All the stuff and things. I'm gonna turn this slightly this way. I think now you can kind of see us. We'll do that. Okay, thank you for being with us as we get everything set up. So this is the stuff I had left over last time, so it should still be good.
Okay. I'm going to record off of these two.
Oh, that'll be a good one to record off.
So let's get each of those set up. Recording. I think this will be fun. Okay. So this is the size, is what this goopy water stuff is called. Did you explain that already?
No. So, yes. I just poured what's known to marblers as size. It's just water thickened with carrageenan, which is an Irish moss. It just makes it thicker so that the paint, and then the paint is thinned so that the paint sits on top of the water. Yeah, okay.
Which is, it's honestly, that's the biggest struggle with marbling, is getting that, the density is right. It's the thing that we struggle with by far the most, and it's taken us forever to get to this point. And even then, we still have plenty of issues where the paint will sink. Occasionally, it'll be so thin that it just, like, hits and it just, like, spreads out because it's too thin. Although that doesn't tend to be our typical issue. Our typical issue is, like I said, that's too heavy still.
Too heavy still.
But.
So, I don't even know what colors we're doing today.
That's a good question. So, we've got a couple different experimental pieces here. So, this one is some new paper that we just bought. And it's what I actually, this is the exact same paper that I used to make the text block for Christmas ornament. So I think, I'm hoping that this will be pretty good stuff, actually. But it's just kind of a cream colored base. So it's just a sort of off-white.
Yeah.
So we'll see how this one works.
Nice and neutral. And then I just did those for leftovers.
And then these are leftovers. Oh, so we just have that.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are super the same. Okay, so that's all we're going to be experimenting with today. So hopefully it goes well, because if not, then we don't really have any other papers pre-prepped. So that's okay.
I've got random colors, Alan, I think.
Yeah, well, that's fine. Oh, wait, dude, really?
I can see what I have.
We might do something else. We'll see. But for sure, we'll do these. So what do you guys think? I'd love to hear your guys' feedback. So like I said, this is going into a Christmas ornament. So we could do like the traditional red and green colors of Christmas. But it's going to go into like a nice leather-bound sort of book. And then the Christmas ornament itself, the book itself, is of the nativity story. So I feel like green and red's kind of more of like a Santa Clausy tradition. Don't necessarily associate with like the nativity tradition. So I was thinking blues.
Blues are very...
I see like some nice dark blues, maybe. Maybe some like gold colors mixed in. I don't know. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Let us know. Just put it in the chat. We can probably do two main color schemes, I think. So we'll flush out this.
Gold, yeah, more just like a warm yellow. More I don't gold. Have metallic paint.
Well,
I wish
yeah.
I had metallic paint.
But so this is our, so this would be like our gold that we will probably use.
That mixed with this. I think I might have.
That would be really fun though, actually, to get some like metallic paints.
I also want this color.
That's very yellowy though.
Yeah.
Maybe that one's too brown though. I don't know.
Yeah.
So we might have to make some stuff together, experiment. Gold is really hard. Like, to get, like, a to get like a matte material to be that gold.
That was our Brissinger.
That was our whole Brissinger struggle.
All Brissinger struggle.
Which, by the way, we have some funny stories about all of that. So, we'll probably tell that tonight.
Okay. So. Blues and golds?
Blues and golds.
Like, maybe like a starry night?
So I was thinking, so we can come in, we can do some sort of pattern, and then come over and just fleck some gold on top, just that brown or that yellow, just on top, kind of give like a starry night sort
of. And then a little bit of white, like just barely white.
Yeah, I kind of want to do some fantasy marbling. So you have different styles, different patterns for marbling.
Yeah.
I don't know if we have any examples.
Yeah.
Got some stuff.
I thought a whole stack of seconds.
Because that's kind of the other thing that we got to decide on. So not just like the color scheme, but there's like traditional patterns, I guess, that you do for marbling as well. So you have like chevrons. You have the peacock tails. Oh yeah,
whole stack of seconds.
Okay.
Here, let's pull up. Maybe let's just switch it to red for a minute, and just turn this guy.
Yes, I'm gonna do that. So here, that's a good example of some chevrons. So some of these got messed up, and that's why they're just kind of sitting over there. This one, what happened was there was some size that didn't dry fully, and when it got wiped off, it took the paint with it, so we got this lovely S little thing left in there, so we couldn't really use this sheet. But the chevron patterning, so if you see that one, that's what that looks like.
There's a combs.
This is the comb pattern, so it's a little bit tighter of a pattern. You see there? Actually, this one's good. We could probably
use
this for a different project.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad.
I guess we'll see on that one. This one's kind of closer to, like, a fantasy marbling.
That one was supposed to be peacock tails.
Supposed to be peacock tails, but we failed.
So. Most of these are... Oh, these are, like, all my oil marbling. Most of these aren't very...
Yeah. Oil marbling is very difficult. It's kind of it's a style in and of itself that can be hard to do.
I think that was one of the first ones we did with our combs.
Yeah. Well, I can show you even just, like, the steps to get to, like, even this point.
I don't know. These are all... This was...
Because sometimes it's fun to just see, like, you know, how far we've come. So, like, this is what happens when you don't alum properly. You see the colors are just really washed out.
Faded.
It's okay, right? It's not horrible, but it's just not
and
the...
And then if the paint... And then the paint was also too thick. And so you see it didn't spread. So you can see a lot of the white paper.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, so this paper is actually this color green, but you can hardly see it on this side. And so, it's just interesting.
Yeah, there's only, like, small pockets where the original green is actually poking through. Same thing for this one.
Mm-hmm.
This one's actually yellow. but this yellow that you see here is paint. That's not even the original yellow from the... This is gray. So, anyway, so you can see, like, kind of how far we've come. This one's, like, fun. I mean, these are fun, but you can just tell.
They're just not...
You know, they've come a long way.
Great.
So yellow gold is my opinion. That's what I'm thinking. Maybe, like, I'm thinking about doing one color scheme with, like, a dark blue. And that gold speckled on top. And then think about doing one that's the red and the gold. So kind of this similar color scheme. It'll obviously be better quality than that. But something kind of similar to that. That's my thing.
Anyway, so lots of different patterns and things. And all this is, like... paste paper. This is...
Oh yeah, and this is what
we started with.
This is what, if you see like YouTube videos of people doing shaving cream marbling, that's what that looks like. It's not nearly to the same quality as the other stuff. It's fun still.
Yeah, it definitely
gets a fun effect, but this stuff rubs off super easy too.
Yeah, we've learned a lot.
Definitely needs to be sealed in.
So we gotta figure out what kind of pattern we want to do.
Combs are just so traditional, but... That's true. I don't know, I think fantasy would look really cool too.
What I'm thinking about doing is a base layer with combs. Then we'll come back in with a lighter color, like a white. So like we'll start with a field of blue.
Yeah.
Kind of what I'm thinking. Maybe two different shades of blue. And we'll do some combs with that. Then we'll speckle in some type of lighter color, either gray or a white,
mm-hmm.
and fantasy that. And then we'll speckle the yellow just very, very fine on top.
Okay.
Like very, very, very fine mist of that speckling.
Yes. So you know what you're doing. So am I handing the reins over to you?
So this one, we can probably get the daubers, pictures of big fields of blue. So we don't. Well, I guess we can use these.
Yeah, actually, it's
just... So we have different ways that you can apply the paint, even.
Where are the crafts?
So, like, here's one example. These brushes have, like, these fuzzy sort of ends on it. And so I use that, we'll just kind of...
Yeah, it's...
Flick paint everywhere. It's great.
Makes it a wonderful mess. Traditional horsehair brush used in Turkey. So... Just get these.
So that's one way you can do it, or you can do like a just like a eyedropper type of thing to apply the paint. Though that gets you some really big globs.
I think we should just use the brushes.
Okay,
get it more even.
We can do that. I almost wanted to use like a toothbrush though for like the fine.
You could do a toothbrush for that. I've got one sitting over there.
Okay, I'll grab one.
Okay, I'm just gonna mix up these paints here. Let's see if I can. This back just a little bit. We can see the paints. Oh,
that's kind of floppy. Sorry.
Does not want to be there. Okay. So blues.
Yeah, and so then a toothbrush is like the last thing that we use, and this gets like a really, really fine spray. It's like a mist almost.
Oh, although you were recording on that one, weren't you?
That's fine.
Are you recording on the red one?
Well, all three of these are. Oh, okay. I hit record on.
So, that's fine.
So.
Okay, so I've got those. If you want black, make it like a dark night. Or is black too black?
No, we can do that. So, yeah, there we go. Those three colors for the base.
And then I've got... Dog sat on it. It's all covered in hair.
She just wanted to use it as a blanket. It's
before we took her to the groomer. Silly dog. Okay.
No, this should be fun.
Just mixing these up. I have this really fun light blue that we could use on top.
That can be used as like our fine one after we comb it.
I've got this white or gray thing we could do.
Yeah, we'll do that one. And then we can even do speckle both of those yellows if you wanted to. Well, no. Let's just do one because I only have the one toothbrush. So, I guess you decide.
This is dark.
That's kind of like a brown beige.
It's a yellow ochre if that's what it is. I might have to shake this guy. It's just really full to stir. I don't like to shake him because it makes a lot of bubbles, but I might have to. So, thank you all for your patience.
Decide. I'll just hold the top now. So, what do you guys think? Looks a little bit more gold. This one that I have that's kind of a little bit more
brown.
A brownish gold, or this brighter yellow. Kind of when you think of gold, which one kind of comes a little bit more close? What do you guys think? So that darker beige color is the one that Loretta's mixing right now.
I just gotta get all the bubbles out of it.
Which I think totally could work.
Yeah, it's like it's a sienna is what it is. So there's kind of it. You see it on the stick. How it colors it.
So, okay, so you like the darker one, Faith? Okay. Not head saying the same thing, the brownish. That's kind of what I'm thinking. We might need to pour it out and mix it with a little bit more yellow just to...
Yeah, and then there's this one.
Yeah, that one's definitely too, like, canary yellow, I think.
It's but it, not but canary. If we... Do you want canary? This is canary. This is canary.
Yeah, no.
So you can see the color difference there between like yellow and.
But still, I think that one's a little bit too orange. But if we mix just a little bit in of that.
This one.
Oh wait, is that?
That one is these two.
Oh okay. Yeah, no, we don't want that one. Do you have any other jars? Is that it?
I mean, I can clean out a jar. There's probably old paint in those. That I can clean out a jar. Okay, so the darker one. So we can just start
I'm thinking the darker one, but it looks very dark.
It is very dark.
That's why I just kind of want to lighten up a little bit of this stuff with some of that.
Okay, well, this one's really old. Let me go wash this out if you want to do the
Okay, I'll start getting these going then. So I'll start getting just the layers of blue. Now you got to think, when the paper goes down, right, that what we're seeing on the top is actually going to be on the bottom of the page.
No, it doesn't work that way. No. What's on the bottom is on the bottom. That's how. It's like painting on water, and then what's going to be on top is going to be on the top of the paper.
Yeah. As long as you get the size off properly. So.
So, because if you, what was going to be on the bottom on top, you'd start with the yellow. But you want the blue background. It's not what you said. Throw me nuts when you say that.
Okay, so here we go. We'll just start with a little bit of the black because we don't want this to overpower our blues. But I love that. You can see how well that just like spreads out. That's exactly what we're looking for. Try to find some like Italian music because we're like Florentine marbling. So I guess this stuff works. This one feels a bit heavy, so.
And you need like barely any paint. Like it'll be look like there's no paint on the water. That's how it should look like anyways.
Yeah, so I'm just going in order. So black, dark blue, the lighter blues. So we can kind of keep these brushes straight.
Okay, I've got a clean jar. So is this like hydro dipping car parts?
You could. You could do it similarly. But I imagine that when you hydro drip car parts, you don't have to worry so much about bubbles. And that's going to be our biggest worry as we're doing this. So as we're laying the paper down, if that paper is warped in any way, shape, or form that we get a bubble, then it can mess the whole thing up. So as you're dipping like a part, so you could marble like say a bowl or something like that. But if it doesn't have a uniform sort of surface area to it, then you can trap air as you're putting it down. And well, it would just mess up the whole thing. So... And I imagine when you hydro dip car parts that it's a little bit more forgiving on the bubble side for the uniform.
Yeah, I've seen like 3D marbling where they like dip shoes and stuff, and I think it is a slightly different process. Like the medium you use for the paint is different.
Yeah, it's because it has like almost more of like a plasticky, filmy sort of barrier on the top. So I'm not exactly sure.
One?
That's what I'm thinking. Just a little bit and then mix that together. And I think that'll get us closer to a gold.
Let's see what this is doing.
Yeah, better. It's kind of more of a caramel color, actually. I don't know.
Yeah,
what do you think?
It just like caramelized. We just caramelized the paint.
Do we dare try adding some of that canary?
No.
No? Oh, no, because that would make it green. That's right, we tried that before. It like just greens the brown.
Yeah. If anything, yeah, I would add red or something, but.
So, okay, we'll start running the combs through this though, because this was the base layer that we wanted.
All the stuff and things. Okay, I'm gonna close this yellow, because I don't think we want this bright yellow.
No.
It's good for mixing, but it's way too bright by itself.
Well, and even then, you gotta be very particular about the. Colors that you mix it with, because it can be very finicky. Okay, so I think I'll just do a little bit of comb like that. Not a ton.
Are you not gonna like mix the colors really well?
Well, I'm going to, because I kind of wanted to go more for like a fantasy vibe anyways. So that's where we got to do the light blue now. The grayish.
So you're going to add that color and then do more fantasy and then speckle the
correct
colors on top.
Yep.
You can just use a popsicle stick if you want. I don't have an awl. You can use the awl if you want it too.
Oh, so cool. Just use the popsicle stick. So that way what we're getting is kind of this feathering going on. I don't know if you can see that super well. You'll see it when we reveal it with the paper, of course, but there's kind of this feathering going on in there. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, it's like pushing the combs.
So now we just need to go for that very, very fine mist.
Do you want gloves?
No.
Okay, you just go wash your hands.
We'll just go with brown hands this time.
Just look at that and all the other colors of paint that I have laying out. Those are their OG jars.
Oh my gosh. Do it.
Do it!
Let's put the paper on. Okay, that looks really, really cool, I think, honestly. I don't know if you can really see that. That's like beautiful. That's exactly what I kind of envisioned. So this is part's kind of easier if two people do it. Again, just to keep any bubbles from forming under the paper, because it is not very forgiving.
Really thick too, so
you gotta make sure it goes all the way to the edge, on every edge. Okay.
Do you want to be the one to pull it out? I always mess it up when I pull it out.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Just a nice soft. Go. Whoa, holy cow. Yeah, grab that camera.
Which one?
I should have like had an apron or something here. I'll let it go.
Always. Okay.
Let me just grab a napkin and rinse some of that off a little bit.
I'll change that. So this is what we got. Sorry,
the lighting is terrible down here.
It's on the floor.
But
we're all shadowy. But that's how it turned out. What do y'all think?
I don't know, I really like it. So, like I said, you got this feathering kind of stuff going on in here. I definitely think that light blue spread out too much. So, probably for the next one, we'll use less of that light blue.
I don't think I'd use it at all.
You don't think you'd use it at all?
I would just use the dark blue and the black.
I see a jellyfish. Yeah, I can kind of see that, like, right here. but I love the speckling of the yellow in there. And then what's great is that it kind of lightens up. Because it's so thin, right, that you don't get that really, really dark brown color. It definitely lined up, I think, to like the perfect tone.
But that can also be an issue with the alamine. So that's one way you can tell if your paper is alumed enough. Because alum should keep your colors bright. But if they fade, then you don't have enough alum on your paper. So if you ever try marbling at home, that's one of the things.
I think it's fine though, honestly.
Okay.
I like it. We'll just, yeah, put less of that light blue in, if at all. But anyway, so story time as we're kind of filtering this stuff out. So I finally took some advice and posted my stuff up on Reddit, and it was awesome. We got like this. We got some really good feedback actually from a few different groups that I posted stuff. But for some weird reason, like...
It's just a second. I'll just take that off.
Yeah, so that's just to, like, kind of clear out the paint that's in there. But... Anyway, so for some weird reason, like, our Harry Potter books just are not getting, like, a lot of traction. And I think I might have talked about that last stream. And I don't really know what it is. Like on our Instagram or anywhere, Harry Potter just weren't getting a lot of traction. So I'm like, I don't know. We'll kind of see what's going on. So I experimented, like, posting it on Reddit. And it's done fairly well there. But I was, like, checking out, like, some different communities. And I saw one that was called Our Bookshelf. So people take pictures of their bookshelves with like their book collections or whatever and kind of promote it that way. And so I was like, I've never really seen this community before, so I'll just like throw up my Aragon book.
Oh yeah, your Aragon.
So I put the Aragon books up there on that one. And that one like really took off. So where I posted the Harry Potters, that did okay. But where I posted the Aragons, that one like took off again, which is this kind of blowing my mind, because in my opinion at least, the Aragon design is just okay. But I really, you know, tried hard on the Harry Potter designs, but I was like, you know, whatever, we'll just see kind of how this goes. And what's funny, so somebody actually found our post, our store through Reddit, and so we have another Aragon order, which is great, you know, no complaints there, so we're gonna be making another Aragon set here soon. But the moderators just went and quietly took it away, so I was like, oh man. I think they're mad because, like, the picture I took wasn't of my books actually on a shelf. I'm not really sure, like,
that's what, we'll
what the problem is, but I don't know. Reddit mods. Is there... I don't know. Reddit mods.
Okay.
What can you really say?
I'm just gonna mix this.
So we got that, but, like, yeah, I just don't know, like, what's wrong with the Harry Potters. Maybe it's just not a good design. I don't know.
I don't know how to market.
Or you see the market crafter, better.
I'm a marketer.
I don't really know.
Okay. Yeah, so I would just do the darker colors because I think we'll get a higher contrast.
Yeah. Totally could. So we'll do that. I think we'll
just
do...
like really shake the paint off. You don't want a lot of paint on your brush.
I know. So what I think I'm going to do is just the three blues. So I'm going to do the black and the dark blue.
Because this is actually a really light blue.
And then I'm going to comb that, and then I'm going to do the medium blue.
Okay, that's perfect, because that'll come out black. Oh, I just do one more.
So does that make sense? I'm going to, do the black. Sure. This blue, we'll run the combs through it so I get that feathering effect again. Because I kind of like the fantasy style. This is just a very...
Oh, that's not like falling off.
Blue.
Like they should.
I know, it's kind of globby still. I don't know.
Okay, I would like mix the colors well, though. That's what I would do. So you don't have big globs of color. They're like more mixed.
I know. Well, that's kind of why we wanted to use these in the first place, but it didn't.
Let's use the other.
They just flaked out in big.
Rake.
You don't like the feathering?
I do. I just think you should mix the blue and the black more first. That's all. Because there's still a lot of... Whatever.
I don't know.
Just gonna whack it. Gonna get paint everywhere. It's marbling. You will get paint everywhere.
Okay, so we'll kind of do it like that.
Yeah, just pull them thinner. There you go. So you can get marbling, but you don't get like the big globs like that.
No, those ones I don't know.
So like push the other color into it then. There you go.
Okay, so we'll do that, and then I definitely love that speckling, so we'll do that again.
I'll let you know when I make a post there. Thanks, Nahid.
This kind of came out a little globby. So we'll see how this one turns out. Might be a little...
Bit. This paper is just really thick, so I'll try it. Is there a spot? Because this is kind of a smaller page. I mean, I could do it this way.
If you want to.
What do you think?
You could, yeah. That works, so that way we kind of avoid that.
I kind of...
Left-hand side, so yeah. Yep. it is, like, right on the edge. So hopefully that doesn't mess with anything. I don't think it should, but well, I guess we'll see. Okay. Yeah, I kind of push it away from the corners, or the sides, but it's okay. True.
That middle is really pretty. Ooh, all those big speckles right in the middle. I think that's really pretty.
Yeah, definitely.
You see a lot of the paper, though, coming through. That was just...
No, that's what I was saying. I think you need to put more paint down, so you're telling me not to put more paint down.
We can't win today.
It's okay.
I'm done.
It's okay. I think we should just put a little bit more of that blue down.
The light blue?
No, that dark blue.
Yeah, that one. I think that one's. I'm gonna have to remake my alum solution because that looks really pale.
So I'll show you the contrast here, real quick. So, I'm gonna go ahead and hit the... Oh, I got it. Okay, so you can see the contrast there, right? The one on the right is the one that we did the first time. See how dark the colors got to there versus the one on the left. So, again, this is just the struggle of marbling. It can be difficult just to get that balance. Right.
So
there's so many things that could...
colors? Or do you want to switch to red... the red and gold.
Let's try it one more time. Just because we have all the paints out. Okay. So we have how many? Six to do?
Step on that.
So we have six to do?
Yes. Okay. And then I've got second. We can marble this one too. We can marble on blue if you want. Do you want to marble on blue?
Yeah, we can try that. I guess we got it here, right? So.
Yeah. Marble.
Okay, we'll do that. Okay. Okay.
Finally got my graphics card back, not headsets. Let's hope it works.
What was it? Was that a 2080? I can't remember now. So you want this one to be on the blue paper? Or do you
We'll do this one on the blue. Just
oh, really? Okay.
No?
I want to do one more on the cream, and then we can... Oh, jeez. Yeah, okay, I just want to do it. I'm trying to spread that before.
I have to put more black on top. That might help.
Oh, true. Hard to get it to like speckle exactly where you want it.
Just add more black on top.
More?
Mm-hmm.
Than that? I mean, I speckled black in there, but
it's just so
I think it's hard to see, but it is there.
Okay. If you're happy with it.
I just don't want to keep messing with it. Sometimes I think you just have to cut your losses. I tried.
This blue is just very light. See, it almost looks white. Clumping like that. I was hoping they would send me a 3080 Ti, but no luck. It is a new card, though.
Well, hopefully it just doesn't have the same, like, thermal issues that you were having before. Maybe I'll just try a peacock design, actually. We'll just speckle that yellow on top of the peacock.
That works.
Peacocks are just almost so classic, they're kind of boring to me.
Really? But it's like your favorite design.
It is. It also isn't, because like I said, it's kind of boring, just because everybody does it. But
everybody does it?
Well, I feel like it. Okay, so this one we just gotta really make sure that we don't have big clumps. We'll go with that. That does look fun to me. Okay. And we do have plans to get a new marbling tray here soon.
Yeah. One of the reasons why I didn't want to do Pride and Prejudice today.
Oh, okay. I see.
Because I didn't have a larger marbling tray, but because these books are small, we can get end pages out of one sheet of paper.
Ooh. I like that. Yeah. Okay.
Ooh, show the camera, show the folks. There you go. I don't know if you can see that.
Show the folks at home.
I love it.
Okay, and now we can move on to a different color scheme. Unless you want to do that blue one. We can do whatever you want with that blue one. Because yeah, that the blues are going to show up very differently on it.
Yeah.
So. I'll let you take over for that one. You can do whatever design you want.
Is like barely too long to fit. I'm gonna start with this blue.
Got like size all over my hands. It feels like really weird, just why I keep rubbing them.
Thick in water.
Yeah. Definitely should get like some type of an apron, I think, for this, but.
I know.
Whatever. Watch this like flip plant on the camera lens. That would be just our look.
Probably. Like I said, marbling just gets everywhere. So, let's see. Do I have any other colors next to here? I thought I had a blue, but I don't. What's this? Is that just black? With, that just might be black with oxygen.
Oh, that because we tried to thin it out.
But this doesn't seem too thick, so.
No, you're fine.
I don't know what our deal is. I just want to keep it, like, super dark. So I might just try and mix these well together. Separating over here, do you see that?
Mm-hmm. Could be. I've seen that happen before. At least it's on the edge there.
Yeah.
So there's a good chevron kind of look.
I might go through and make some, really some good swirly whirlies.
Good feathering. Oh, you like do full circles.
Mm-hmm. It gives it a different look. Those lights are almost like too bright for it. Let's try this guy. I might add some other colors to this as well. I did get a big drop up there.
Yeah. Like I told you, I kind of have to like really shake it to get that stuff out.
That was a really good, I didn't even like put it any in the dropper. I just like hit it off.
Careful.
As I get blown up. Oh, the whimsicalness of marbling. And this is just so fun. Can I like suck it up? No?
I don't think that'll work.
No?
Because you gotta suck it from like the very surface.
Might just go whimsically move it around and make it look purposeful. Let's see what we got. Alright!
Whoa!
The Hunter!
Hey, the Hunter, how's it going? Welcome in, welcome in. We're doing some fun marbling today. Red is just experimenting with different styles and things. How did your stream go, the Hunter?
What are you working on today?
It went really well. Well, that's good. Glad to hear it. What project are you working on today? Huh? Yeah, I'd maybe do that one more time just right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just having fun over here. I love marbling days because it's just so cash, you know? You just... You can experiment, do whatever you want.
What is really going on?
Got a lot of tooling done and dye job for my first commissioned passport cover. Hey, well, that's nice. Congratulations. You know, first of all, on commission, that's super exciting.
Commissions are always fun.
Yeah, commissions are always fun. Is this like your first commission ever, or is just your first commissioned
passport
cover? I'm assuming it's just your first commissioned passport cover, because you've been doing this for a while, right? That's way cool. If you have pictures, feel free to... drop it in the chat. I'd love to bring it up. Like, if you got anything like on Instagram or something. Okay, so it's your fourth overall, but gotcha. First
nice.
Passport cover itself.
Sweet, sweet.
That's way cool. Yeah, I would just leave it like that. Just the big globs.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go. We're gonna do the big reveal on this one. Oh, this will be fun too on the blue paper.
Mm-hmm.
You only gotta press really on the tail end. There you go. Okay. Ooh.
Here, whoa. Let's just pick it out of the corners and hold it on the camera.
Oh, I'll just bring the camera down.
Okay. Again. This turned out way better than I thought it would.
So the that like yellow color with the blue behind it kind of turned almost like a bronze. So. We'll get the camera on that in just a minute as I get... I just need to wipe the paint,
paint inside
off my finger. Yeah, once it's done dying, I'm going to toss them up on the gram. Nice. LOL. When that happens.
Yes.
Okay.
Just grab red.
Yeah, flip it over.
Sorry.
Okay. So here we go.
These motion sickness.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, that looks really dark on camera. But I guess you can kind of see... Right, the how the yellow turned bronze. So, but I like it. That turned out really, really good. So here was the first attempt.
That's dope. Thanks, the Hunter. So this is called a paper marbling.
Yep.
So we just have some thickened water. Yeah, so we have some thickened water and some thinned acrylic paint. And then we just kind of splatter it all on top and make a picture. It's like painting on water.
This one's just our refuse.
That one's just refuse, yeah, that one doesn't matter.
We just use that one to clean up the...
So it's just, yeah, so it's like painting on water. We just kind of splatter it around, mix it up, and put it on paper. The paper does have,
It has alum on it.
It has alum on it, and so... It's a mineral that allows the paints to be more bright and adhere to the paper. So.
I've never seen this before. That's awesome. Yeah, I really like it. It's a traditional sort of technique for making end papers in books. So that's why we do it. And these are going to go into our Christmas ornaments. So we have some of these really, really small books that we're going to make that can be hung on a tree. And these are going to be the end papers for those books. So, it's going to be a lot of fun. So, that's why we're kind of going for like a starry night sort of idea, because it's going to, the book itself is going to contain the nativity story. So, that's why we did like the field of blue with the speckled bronze and gold.
I'm just going to empty this because we're
going to do... Yeah, that's totally fine.
And I'll just get new size.
Yeah.
So.
I guess I'll just chit-chat for a minute.
Yeah,
So, yeah, actually, I'll show you the books themselves. We got them pressing. So I was working on these in the last stream, and I might need to clean up some of those colors too so we can get some more out here. I haven't even pulled these out of the press yet. So they're made with a very, very thick paper, so they need a heavy, heavy press on them to get them to kind of take shape. So... Anyways, hopefully I don't have any paint on my hands. So I'll show you that. So there you go. This is how small they'll be. It's just the nativity story. And we did it, like I said, on a very, very thick paper. It's kind of like a cardstock. And so that's why they need to be pressed super heavily. So we'll do some end pages for these. We're finalizing the designs for the covers. This is all for the community challenge, by the way. So if you haven't been following with the Craftsman Guild, they put out these challenges, and so the challenge for November, December is to make a Christmas ornament, and since we're bookbinders, we decided to make a book ornament. But, we're still finalizing some of the designs for it. I looked up some brass today, because we're gonna probably put some brass stars on, like, the leather covers for these. There's still a lot of things I need to solve with these. end pages being one, so we're working on those end pages. But I think I'm going to do a case binding for these because that will kind of keep the cost of production low if I can do a case binding. And I don't want these to be like super duper expensive because it's just a Christmas ornament at the end of the day. But there's that.
Paper towel.
Yeah.
Or just shop towels.
Oh, we just have the shop towels. That over here. Yeah, so once we get the end pages done, then I can start sewing the books together, and then we can have the text block done, and I'm going to make the case separate, so that way I can bring them together. That'll save me a lot of time, so I don't have to do everything, you know, one step at a time. And here's just the blank papers that we're putting these on. So if you haven't seen it yet. Oh. Guess we're... Okay, so for this next one, I didn't want to do like a traditional red and green sort of color scheme for these. Maybe we could.
I don't know. It's up to you.
Maybe that could be like a very last one that we do. Be like a red and green. I don't know. Well, I don't want to break out that many colors. They're just such a mess to clean up.
I've got 4 quarts of size, so well, you can do whatever you want.
I'm lazy though. Yeah, we can do whatever. It's fine.
Want me to dump this whole half gallon in here?
Sure. A whole half?
A whole half. So this is, you can see as it's pouring into the tray, it's really thick. So this is just distilled water that's been thickened with carrageenan, which is an Irish moss. which is traditionally used in marbling. And so I use distilled water because minerals in hard water can cause the carrageenan to not thicken properly. Yeah. Although, let's just let that sit for a minute. It had a few bubbles in it.
Yeah, bubbles are like the biggest enemy of marbling. So I think, yeah, for sure this red.
Lurking with cleaning up. No worries, DeHunter.
Hi.
Thanks for raiding and thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
Okay, so you just want this goldy color. Are you done with these two colors or do you want more of... What color?
I don't know, because I was thinking about doing like this brighter yellow with the red. So, I don't know. What do you guys think? I think that'll look better with the red than
this brown one we used.
This brownish one. So, that's my thoughts at least. Okay. I don't know. Oh, here, I'll go rinse these off.
Don't use soap, remember.
I know.
Okay. Put this guy away. I can get this camera on. There we go. You can kind of see our array of colors a little better this way. So yeah, so we're gonna do red and gold. So we did some blue and gold earlier. We'll try some red and gold. Another stick. Pop bubbles. Oh, so many bubbles. I love this deep, like, garnet color. It's one of my favorites to use in marbling. And we have a nice bright red, so they contrast that way. Black, a little mix up. It's looking a little pale. Stirring sometimes just doesn't do it. Sometimes these paints just sit for too long. It's been a while since we marbled. You see, it's quite a process, so we don't pull them out all the time. But when we get our new marbling tray for the bigger sheets, then we'll do it again. It'll be really fun. I'm really excited. Pull out some new brushes, which we could have just washed the brushes all at the end, because I have a lot of these horsehair brushes, so. So I don't know if he wants to use black. Don't think so. Yeah, so you can just set those to dry, because I have dry brushes we can use.
Alright, that's fine.
Did you want black or just red and gold?
I left the black out just in case.
Okay, I
feel like it could add a really nice dark scheme.
Yeah, because this red is super bright. I might mix some of this and this together and then use that color instead of this red by itself. Because that red is really bright, but...
Okay, yeah, so I guess now we can kind of talk styling again. The next big part of the project. What one of these did you like the most? Do you want to try that, doing that similar style again?
I don't know.
Do you want to do just pure fantasy marbling?
Yeah, we could just do that. No combs. I might like get that ball and use like a really fine tip.
Okay. Let's do that then.
But yeah.
So then, yeah, I'll do the black. I'll use all four of those.
Okay, you want the lighter color?
Yeah. You know what I wish I could do is just get like...
I would almost use all five of these.
I almost wish I could use just toothbrushes.
Well, how many do we have upstairs?
I don't know.
Another small delay, my friends. Thank you for sticking around. We will get there until my husband decides what he wants to. So I'll just clean the bubbles off of this. Any debris on top.
Okay, so here's this toothbrush washed out. I'm gonna go check. We should probably just buy like a bunch of these because they're so useful.
Do you want to use these paintbrushes here? Or are they not stiff enough?
No, it needs to be the hard bristle. And then it has to have that large surface area too.
Okay.
The bristle head.
Yeah. Okay.
So, I'll be right back.
Let's see what we have. So we're going to see if we have more toothbrushes hanging around. So, thank you for your patience, my friends. But how's everybody's night going? It's not super late here, but... Did you find some?
Yeah, I think enough. We should just definitely, I think, order a whole bunch
just
of, like...
bunch of...
These ones? Hard bristle, I think, would work a little bit better.
Okay, because these are all soft bristles, I think. But they're toothbrushes, so...
They're soft to medium, it feels like. Some are a little softer than others. I don't know, maybe they're all the same, but... anyways, but I think these should work. These are, like, the free ones. They come from, like, the dentist. What was it? Do we just leave second there?
Because
forever.
We prefer other brands.
Yep. Okay, maybe I will wear a glove for... No. Because I can wipe off my finger a lot easier. Can we grab a stack of napkins?
A stack of napkins, yes, sir.
Yeah, I can wipe off my finger a lot easier than I can wipe off a glove finger. Okay. I don't know, I think like these work really, really well for the large... I don't know what you call them. The large trays. But...
Well, I didn't have that big of an issue with them.
I don't know, but yeah, our application, we're going for such a small pattern.
It's true, because it's going to be on such a small little book.
Exactly. So that's why I think this stuff is going to work better. Alright, well, I guess I'll just dive in.
So it's just going to spread out, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, just remember that.
So.
That's fine. Perfect.
Okay. And then just same thing, I'll just go from darkest to lightest. But yeah, I think
first
for this one...
First time chat! Welcome in!
Hello! What did they say?
Noogie? Can I call you Noogie? I just asked everyone about everybody's night is. Yes, we're having fun marbling. Thanks for joining us. What made you decide to stop by today? Always love first-time chatters.
Oh, man. Yeah, I think doing a fantasy marbling on this is going to look really good, actually. Like, look at that. I don't know if you can... Can you kind of see that developing in the camera? Maybe
can,
not quite
kind of.
Yet. But, I guess just take it from me. It looks pretty cool. it's giving me, like, Sumitagashi sort
just like
of vibes.
Crafting nice.
Ooh, this one... It's because of the uneven surface of the toothbrush kind of...
Yeah.
Glops it out.
Okay, and
that's
that,
okay, though.
I mean, that one's just a really bright red, so... It's like,
you're just really worried.
I guess.
No, we're just gonna have fun. We're just gonna try it.
We're just gonna see. Go for it. Nice. Yeah. So paper marbling is kind of rare for us. It's something that we do on the off days. But we're primarily bookbinders around here. So stick around, give us a follow, and
don't do that.
Just add more colors on top.
Yeah, I'll switch back to some more of this dark red.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Oh, man. I must have accidentally dripped.
I think so.
And I didn't notice.
It's really spreading out there at the bottom.
I dripped again. Right there, that one's gonna spread out.
That didn't really do
anything. Yeah, I think we'll just rock and roll it with it. It is what it is.
Do you want to throw more black on top of that yellow? Would that help? Or no?
Yeah, I could try. Just a smattering. Whoa. Okay. You know what? Yeah. Whatever. It is what it is.
Okay.
I like it. So this is fantasy marbling, where we don't really do anything else with it.
We'll just swirl it, though. Are you gonna leave it like that?
Yep. That's what I'm thinking.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. We can just try one. We can do something different with the other ones, but I think I'm just gonna leave it just like that. Hopefully Pixar doesn't flag us. I wasn't paying attention to where the music was going at all, but whatever. Hell yeah.
So there's that reveal there.
Yeah, I love it. That's exactly what I think I wanted. I love the intermixing of the different red tones.
Yeah, that was good. We'll just lay that out. Don't step on it.
Yeah, maybe we can start moving some of those other ones off the... Okay, let me take you over to see it a little bit more zoomed in. It's a little curled right now, but I don't know. That looks really cool. There you go, yeah. If you look here, you can definitely see in the camera a little bit better the different shades of the red poking through. So, I don't know. I really like it. That's a fun one. Okay, so yeah, so I'm just gonna move some of these pages over so I don't accidentally step on them. But they dry relatively quickly, actually. It's not too bad.
Slightly off center here, just a bit. There we go. A few bubbles over here. What do you want?
Oh my gosh, I really like that. All right.
Yeah, that lighter gold turned out really nice. That lighter yellow.
I really like it. So, and then once these are dry, I'll put a sealant on it that'll actually kind of help the colors pop just a little bit more. It won't be like a huge difference, but they will pop a little bit more.
Does it layer on the paper?
Does it layer on paper? Yeah, it does.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So it's like kind of like painting on water. So what's on the water will be what the paper looks like. It is just layering. So we layer the paint and it layers on the paper.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that it's... Good.
I know.
That the paint is designed, it doesn't mix together. So, right, so we did red and yellow separately, but we didn't get orange. And so that's what I really like about marbling, too.
Yeah. I know. I think that one turned out really, really good. The colors actually appear a little bit brighter on camera than they do in person.
Yeah.
Like that yellow. It's really just yellow, actually. The red's pretty accurate.
The yellow is definitely more like it is in this camera up here.
Yeah.
I
don't know if that's just lighting or whatnot, but no, I really like it. I think it's got some fun depth to it.
Yeah. So, you have another sheet over there. I was like, I'm not missing a sheet. But...
Okay, so we can do, well, I did that one, so if you want to do your own design.
I might start with...
It's really hard to go wrong with marbling, really. You know, you can just do whatever you want and just have fun with it.
More
so.
Red. I just love this red color.
But I'm really excited to see how these books turn out. In fact, I wonder if I should be posting progress pictures on the
Gram?
On the Discord.
Or the Discord, yeah.
Yeah. Not so much the Gram, but yeah, on Discord.
Yeah, we could do that.
Careful, you really got paint everywhere with those last couple of flicks. It's okay.
It's marbling. This is how you get it to spread out like that. I told you, it gets everywhere.
I know. We just don't have everything covered in here.
We tried.
I know. We just need a better studio space than an unfinished basement.
It works, but when we're trying to do everything in an unfinished basement.
It's better if you use your pointer finger than your thumb.
It's just gonna be like gloopy and like fade.
Well, that's fine, depending on kind of your...
Mm-hmm.
Pattern. Depending on how, uniform you're trying to get it to be.
I might just swirl these a little bit.
So you like the fantasy as well? Fantasy is just fun sometimes. I like the regular, patterning of
the
combs.
Are almost
the
like
combs sometimes,
too...
but. Traditional?
Uniform.
Not too, I guess.
Just giving it a go.
Yeah, don't hold it down because it's spraying up. It sprays out from your finger.
You do this more than you use toothbrushes like this more than I do.
It's okay.
It's just I probably just got that everywhere.
Yeah. Hopefully, it doesn't look like it got on the lens, but.
There's just like a big spot. Let me know.
Yeah, this is where it drips off. I try to touch it down on something to get those big drips off.
Probably do that. Do little swirls up here. I kind of like how it's fading, honestly. It's
just
really
go for it.
Interesting. Put a little bit of this on too. This is a small set of brushes.
So I think with these, are we gonna cut these in half to get our book?
No, we
out
can
of?
Cut them in fourths.
Cut it in fourths. Oh, so we can get two books out of.
So one, so a fourth of this, these pages.
It's got to fold in half, though, remember.
Yeah, so we can still cut it in fourths, eighths. These books are tiny. Because I take, so these pages, so 8.5 by 11 sheet cut into fourths and then folded twice. So it's 2 inches.
Okay, yeah, so we'll get...
So we'll have a lot to work with.
We'll get at least two books out of each.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
like that speckling on top. It's really fun. Okay.
Perfect.
I think that's my pattern.
Roll that guy up.
Is this the alum side? I assume because it's curling up into it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, I like this one.
I wonder how the two-tone. I almost want to put this on the red paper.
And do it. We'll just lay that to the side and
maybe I'll get
too much red. I don't
know. No, I want lots of red.
Okay, go for it.
I don't know. I don't know now that you said that.
Because all this will become red up here.
Yep. You said.
We'll just do that page.
Okay.
I can't decide. Makes me a woman, right?
Typical woman. Okay.
These pages are just so small.
And so what we're doing there, I don't know if we really explained that, is we're scraping
the size
off on like the side of the tank.
So there it is. That's what I did.
Yeah, I like it.
I like it. I kind of do like how it fades into nothing. But that's like a good piece by itself, but I guess we could cut out little endings.
It is very pink on the cream though. The cream.
Yeah, you know, honestly, this paper's so good. I don't really think we need a whole lot of colored paper. Like if we want to use this for other projects, we totally could. We don't have to get the colored
just like
Canson paper.
The only issue is that the size of the paper.
Yeah. True.
So this is good for tiny projects, for small projects, but, right, this size of paper here. So this is a quarter sheet. So I buy, like, huge sheets of paper, of this colored paper. You didn't see that in that camera. So a quarter sheet, I call it a quarter sheet because it's a big sheet that's cut into fourths. It fits in this little tank, but this is big enough for one end sheet in our leather-bound series, our leather-bound books. And so I want a tank that's at least big enough for half a sheet so that I can get two of the same pattern out of it. Because I've been trying to replicate patterns, and I've been doing okay. We've been doing okay to replicate patterns, but it would just be easier to
It's like impossible, right? You can never get like the exact same marbling setup twice in a row. It's so hard. And so like what I said, it's better for me to get my end pages cut from the same paper so that way the front and the back of the book are nice and uniform.
Okay. I'm just gonna pull a second off of this because I like this pattern so much.
Yeah, so I guess like you said, this would be great for little applications. So until we get that big tank or whatever, I think we could totally just use this paper.
Just some seconds before I script the rest of it off with some random child math.
So how many more we got? We got at least two more, and possibly a three if we want to do something with the green one.
Yeah.
Okay. My turn?
Yes. What?
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 I'm just excited.
Okay.
Try something different again. Although I don't know what I want to try.
Do you want a different color? Want to throw a different color in there?
Yeah, maybe break out some of the greens. Woof. We'll try a red and green.
And I've got a lot of little brushes, a lot of these brushes. So this was that gold color. But so I have the jade is probably gonna be what. Where is my jade?
You probably bust out like two different tones.
I know. Where is my jade though? What am I out of?
That's not it? I thought that was it.
Is this it?
It's just pretty jadey to me.
Oh, it's just very less. There's just not a lot in there.
Just very less.
Very less. I can English. I can English. Yeah, there is a little bit of paint in there.
It is much, not as much.
Much. It's just less than the others. Let's shake that up a bit. Do you want more of that color?
No.
Okay, I'll just put that up there.
We're gonna have to redo stuff for the Aragons here anyways soon.
Yeah, we'll make some new paint up for those guys. So I have that, and then I have the super extra, like, electric green. That's all I have. Which, this almost feels rather empty. I might need new paint. Oh, and I have the emerald. That's right. I have the emerald color, too. So this green might not look so bright. But it turns out, like, electric. It's so bright. Let me pull that emerald out, too. This emerald's a really pretty color. Ooh, mix, 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 mix. Yeah. Really pretty. Yeah, I like that emerald. Let's pop it there, yeah. It's really dark in that corner, but it's like a lighter green. The lids and stuff and things.
Okay. So I guess I'll try this one. Actually, I might. Get these mixed in a little bit.
I'm gonna make these brushes smaller. Ooh, some groovy music. So, these brushes that we use, they're made up of, like, tiny little straws that have been frayed on the ends to mimic traditional horsehair brushes. And so I'm just grouping some together. I had it in, like, a bigger one, but I think I like the smaller sizes better. So I just cut it in half and to make two smaller brushes out of it. So that's what I'm doing over here. Do like the green.
Maybe I'll go for some peacocks again.
Sure. You do love your peacocks.
Okay, we'll see how this one goes.
Ooh, I like like it. What do you think? That face tells me no. Or not quite.
Just wonder if it's two uniforms still for my liking. So. Maybe we'll just rock with it. Because I can't really, like. Well, I can kind of. Mess with the uniformity. We'll see. Let's go. I'll do that, and then I'll speckle it a little, like, one more time. We'll just go with that, I think. So I use my lighter colors to speckle. And I kind of want to try a different way of putting this in. The paper in.
Oh.
Here, I'll show you. I don't know, it was just one of those things I should stop, like, messing with it. But, well, it's just...
No, I think these lights make it really harsh, almost.
Oh, this one? Try turning that one off, then.
I don't know, is that... No, it's the overhead lights. Actually, because we just have, like, two bright dots right in the water. But...
Okay.
Anything that's just shadowing on the camera.
So yeah, so that'll just be very chaotic looking, I think. Which one are you doing? This one?
Yeah.
And that's the arm, so
I kind of curled it. Yeah, that feels aligned on that side. So how did you want to put it in, so I don't mess up your thoughts?
So, what you do is you kind of put it in a little. And a little more. And a little more. And a little more. Nice.
Okay, so when he put it in up and down like that, it created these ridges. And so that is a nice marbling effect that way.
Paper is a little ridges, so it didn't turn out great. But still, I think he's got some fun character to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, now that it's on the paper, though, I'm not sure if I'm totally sold on the green.
I think the green and red by itself would be fun, but not the yellow.
Without the yellow.
Without the yellow.
Alright, well, we get one more, so...
Okay, well, this size is really... Really... Wasted. So I've got another half gallon of size, and we can do these two in, like, a red and green pattern.
You wanna do that? Is that... Yeah. So is that green one ready to go?
I mean, if it's not It's just not gonna be super bright, but we can still marble and see what happens. I've got like three more of those green sheets sitting over there. But I will go dump this if you wanna take over chat.
I guess so. Okay, cool. So, beautiful and nice teamwork. Have a good night. Okay, well, thanks for stopping by. I think Loretta might have already said that. I was distracted, though, with the paint, so I missed that whole part of the conversation. But, yeah, so we're going to have to do a lot more marbling here, because even though we are doing this here tonight, we still have two big projects coming up that we need to get prepared for. First is going to be that Pride and Prejudice series. Well, actually, first is going to be the Aragon series, because that's a commission piece, so I got to get that out the door as soon as possible. So that way we're not sitting on it for like an entire month trying to get it done, because that's how long it took me to get the other ones done. I definitely have more of a routine now with them, so I'm excited to see how quickly I can move through the steps. But we had to order new books for it, because I just do a rebinding, so that's going to get here on Friday next week, I think. So once that's in, and then we had to order more leather and everything for it. But we got to get the marbled end pages ready, because that's always like the biggest kicker, is that if I don't have the end pages ready, then it holds up everything else. I can't get started on making the text block, getting that prepped, until I have the end pages that I can attach to the text block. So that's just definitely something that we got to get out of the way. What I would really like, what would be ideal, is to have like a whole studio set up where I could just go into like a drawer of marble paper and I could just open that up and select, you know, pre-made sheets. But we really have to grow our entire operation before we're ready to mass produce marbled paper that way. But that would be nice though too, because I really want to see how well these marble pages would sell. And I think they would sell fairly well if we took these to a market or just put them on our online store, but we just haven't been able to produce enough of them in mass to do that yet. And as of right now, the only ones that we have pre-prepared are all of like the messed up ones, so
all of the seconds.
Yeah,
it's because we're marblers second, bookbinders first.
Yeah, and there's so many people who do like just marbling full time. You know, that's like their whole studio's gig.
It's all so they do.
There's definitely a lot of tricks of the trade that we haven't mastered yet. But you know what? Honestly, for only having done this for a couple months.
6 months now.
For like 6 months now, I think we're doing pretty good. Pretty okay.
Okay.
So.
Pop that up there. Okay. I've got one more half gallon of size that'll fill this tray up.
And then I'm just going to move these over so I don't
accidentally step on them.
That would be fantastic. Okay, I will try and pour this out with the least amount of gurgling. Get all the bubbles off.
Those lines are growing on me. We could probably do that again.
If you wanted to. Definitely worth another experimentation.
But I think I'm done with the yellow. I think I just want to try the red green.
Okay, that's cool. Is there anything you wanted to do with these?
I might cut a little bit off of the corners and stuff. Okay, so we are gonna set up again for, we just have a couple more pages. A couple more pages that we have prepped, so just gonna clean up some of the colors I have sitting over here. And we to do a couple more sheets. Might pull some of my grays out. Got a light gray and a medium gray. Some beautiful colors I think will go well. The red and green kind of offset those complementary colors. It's kind of like Christmas.
What if you could turn those into, like, snowflakes? Like, if you did, like, a drop and then, like...
You could. I would get the all and do, like, really, like, more Ed Brew stuff.
What? That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, you could do that. Or I could just do white. We could do straight up white. I think the gray would look nice.
But yeah, if you did, like, a dropper, so you got, like, a uniform.
Okay, night, all.
Okay. Have a good night. Thanks for coming. Thanks for the raid.
Thanks for the raid to Hunter. Thanks for staying. Hope you have a good night. Now what?
I don't know.
Oh my goodness, is it the bug land?
Right.
We got a bug?
I don't know what else that little black speck is. Oh no, I'll just clean the surface again. Yeah, he's coming up. Whatever it was. Whoop, right into the camera. My turn? Is that what that is?
Yeah, it's your turn.
Okay.
Go for it.
Let's see what we got.
So, yeah, I don't know what you want to do. No black on this one? Yeah, we need like a marbling shed.
Right.
Or something.
Just to do this in. Can get paint on it.
With like big sinks and tubs and everything. Cause yeah, and there's like a proper way to get the marbling off, which is to have like a nice soft spray of water. But we don't have that set up, so that's why you see us kind of scraping it off on, like, the side of the tank.
Mm-hmm. Other than that, you would just pull it off and then rinse off the extra size. But that is very messy for where we are. Having to carry stuff to and from the basement. So.
Might take some videos for the gram.
Or do it in full, and then we can post it to the story.
You want it as like a story?
Mm-hmm. As I just get that everywhere. Just trying to curl that corner. What do you think? Should I just add some white spots on top? I think I might just add some gray spots on top and try and make them look like snowflakes. I think that would be fun. Okay, which is my lighter gray, though? Light gray, medium gray. Okay, I'm just going to give this gray a bit more of a stir. Looks still kind of separated. I just want don't want to do it over my tank in case I spill, because that would suck. Two came out. So I'm gonna, just gonna pull these colors in and see what that does. It makes them more like flowers.
You might have to do it in and then do out again. I wouldn't do zigzags.
We'll just go with it. We'll just go with it. I just need a napkin for my all. Yeah, that gray paint spread really well.
Too well.
Too well. I'm just gonna try and pull this other color, these other colors back in here, and make kind of a shape. Make kind of a shape. Do you like it? I might put some.
I just speckle it again.
Yeah. First one match how I did the rest of them. Speckle with what color? Red and green?
Start with your lighter red, but yeah.
The lighter red? You like the lighter red?
Or the darker, I don't know. Just, yeah, start with the red, I think.
Brush today. I might do my lighter green, actually. To get my arm in the camera. My lovely arm. Sorry about that, folks. One is a problem child in the corner there. Just drag these colors in now. Whoa! That's kind of fun.
Not bad, actually.
Just kind of in the same pattern. There.
Yeah, I definitely think I like the fantasy. It's just like a little bit more abstract than it is when you use the combs. A little bit more chaotic.
Might have saved it, folks. Might have.
I don't think it was really ruined to begin with, so.
Well, I think the white was just too much.
Just spread too fast, too far?
Yeah.
What are you doing, the red?
Or the green, whichever one.
Let's do the red, I think.
Okay. Hey, I think that'll be fun. What do y'all think? Let's see how it turns out. Placement of the paper.
Okay. Yeah, that red really washed out your white, so I think.
So that's how it turned out. So it's gray, right? So we used the gray, and then on the red paper, it kind of turned it into a pink. But I really like it. I think it turned out good.
Okay. We'll just finish up with that green and then be done for the night.
Yeah. We didn't get to bookbinding, but it's been a fun marbling stream. Thank you, everybody, for hanging around.
Okay, I probably need a little bit before I'm ready to sew those books together anyways. Especially now that we're going to use these on papers. Because before I was going to use some like stuff that we had in stock, but the other one won't work.
I'm like, do we have any, quote, in stock?
Well, not of marble paper. So I'm just going to use like our scrapbook paper.
Oh, our scrapbook paper.
But since we have this, I'll just use this now. So.
Yeah.
But that means I'm going to have to wait for it to dry and then I have to put the finish on it.
So we'll should be ready to sew Sunday.
Yeah.
Next string.
Yeah,
so.
For sure.
Okay.
Okay. So yeah, so if you come by on Sunday, then...
Yeah, on Sunday we should be cutting up these pages that we're marbling today, and then...
Well, I'll probably have them pre-cut down, but I'll be ready.
Yeah, I'll probably have them cut out, but then we'll be sewing our little ornament books. So, that'll be really fun.
Okay, well, let's do it, so...
Yeah.
I think I'll kind of start in a similar fashion. Get my green base going.
Do you want to use that other green? Or not? Just put it away.
That's fine. You can put it away. Ooh, careful.
That was just the comb. These are so fun. I just love marbling. It's very, like, stressful for me sometimes.
I think because you just overthink it.
I overthink it.
You just can't have too much of, like, an idea of how you want it to turn out.
This is true. Because
it's not going to turn out that way.
This is very true.
So, that being said, which one's your lighter one, this one?
Yes. I don't know why they're so separated, though. Ugh. Are struggling. I probably should mix it up before I did that, but yeah, it's not really a dark gray, it's more like a medium gray, but it is slightly darker.
Wow, yeah, even like those were much smaller drops than what you had, but they still just
I'm gonna pop that bubble.
I think I'll try to do the same thing. Bring my colors in. Ebru's just so chaotic.
Ebru?
Yeah.
No. Ebru is where they paint like the flowers and stuff.
Yeah. It's chaotic.
How is that chaotic?
Because
it's way more painting than
it's because it just goes where it wants to go. It just has a mind of its own.
I know. They
you can try to do what you want.
They
but
somehow put like very like minuscule amounts of paint on it and it's like magical. Ooh, that's fun. I love the green stripe coming from the paint on the all. Ooh, I like this one. What do you think, chat? Do you like it? What do you think? Yeah, I love the pattern on this.
Oh.
I like it.
I just wonder if I could, like,
do it again. Maybe I'll just mess it up, who knows? Kind of push it in on the side, and then I'll drag it back out.
Knothead says, don't touch it.
Don't leave touch it.
Now we went from flowers to blobs.
I just want to see if I could get, like, more spiky things coming out of it, but let's just see.
So you're going to pull it out again?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so this is a half step, Knothead. We'll see what we go. We'll see where it goes from here. You want to just clean it off? With the, I've got a rag here.
Okay.
We will see.
Not quite what I was looking for. But I think I also just have two. Big of globs I'm working with.
Otherwise, otherwise in writing and modding everyone. otherwise I am writing and modding.
Papa.
Yeah, we have a pretty chaotic chat, so they definitely need to be moderated. Oh. Those wild goons.
Data always gets auto-modded so bad.
Okay, there we go.
Poor Data.
We'll even see if this sticks to the paper, but I don't know. Just kind of some spiky
if
shapes.
Anything, it's this side that is owned. Because I usually marble though. The only ones we didn't do the textured side on was the Aragon. So, we'll try that.
I don't think it is Alan though, because it feels very
similar. Woo! Camera overboard.
Hello, everybody. Okay.
Good thing I wasn't the main camera, so.
So there you go. That looks good.
I'll just pull it right back under the green camera. So there you go. That's how it turned out.
Yeah, we'll just see. Hopefully those colors won't fade.
Yeah, we shall see.
But yeah, there we go. So that's it for tonight. We're going to start cleaning this off. We got a lot of stuff to clean up because modeling always just makes such a huge mess.
Huge mess.
But anyway, so thanks for being here. I don't know. I had a lot of fun doing this. But, yeah, so we got, oh, wow. Can you maybe just turn?
I'll just turn this guy. There you go.
Yeah, so, anyways, thanks for being here. Thanks for joining in. I have a lot of fun when I marble. But so Sunday we'll start sewing up the books now that these end pages are going to go into, so that's going to be exciting. We got the Christmas books, which is probably all I'm going to work on Sunday. I think that's all we really have stuff prepared for. So come in on Sunday and you'll see us put together those mini books. In the meantime, I think we're going to raid out. I think we're going to go hit Rhino Lion. He does a lot of stuff with clay, so I'm going to send you over there. Yeah, thanks for being here, and hope you all have a great night. And don't forget to come back on Sunday. Okay. All right, we'll see you guys.
We're still alive.